Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Dennis. Welcome to Patina Code. This is So You Want to Build an AD.
I'm cold right at him, Dunn. Come on.
Again, everybody, and thank you for tuning in for this edition of So You Want to Build an AD, powered by LS Fabrication. And as you can see right here on the side of me, we have our car audio sound system components. So you're probably thinking, what the hell are you doing with that shit? You ain't even got the truck done yet. Well, that's the whole thing. We stay ahead of the curve. We always plan ahead when building the vehicles. And in order to install this, we got to have a game plan on what we need to do. I know what we're getting ready to do, but there's one thing that I wasn't quite sure of, so I had to go out and get this stuff. It wasn't no sense in just buying the forward speakers when, since I was at Best Buy, I might as well just buy it all. So that's what we did. And today we're just gonna focus on installing the two little speakers that we need to put up there underneath the dash. This is important because before we can put the sound deadener down and all the rest of the stuff that we need to do inside of the cab, we need to make some brackets to hold these speakers. There's not very much room up in the top of the dash of these trucks once you get the heater up there, once you get the wiper motor back up there. It gets tight real quick with the wiper arms, the ducting for the defrost from the heater hose, and then the various wires that we're going to have run across the inside of the firewall of this truck. So what we need to do is figure out a good place to place these speakers to where they will sound good. Normally, I would go with the square type speakers. They just didn't have those, and I would tuck them like right underneath the dash. They would flow flush with the dash. You couldn't see them unless you were actually looking up under the dash. So what I want to do with these, since they're a round type speaker, we're going to have to put them back. But we want them up. We just have to stay clear of the cowl vent as well as stay out of the path of the heater ducts. We don't want any obstructions. I don't like things rubbing and touching. It's easier to take things apart if you got a clear way in and out with things. So we're gonna figure out a bracketry system for these speakers, get that made up. And then we're also gonna fill in the holes that are above the five windows here, the corner windows in the top of the cab where the previous owner decided they want to put speakers up there. But we're gonna fix that. I don't wanna put speakers up there, and the gaping holes they had put up there were just, they're gnarly. They were messed up. So we're gonna get to all that stuff right now. So let's just hop right into these videos. So even though we've marked and measured 5, 6, 8 times, we've got our bracket welded on, but we still need to go through the process of making sure that it's exactly where it needs to be. Because now is the time to do any tweaking or twisting or bending of the bracket to ensure that everything's gonna fit because of clearance issues. We don't want any. So we're gonna go ahead and install this as if, well, we're installing it because we have to be for sure that this is where we wanna be. We have one bracket left to make. And as you can see, our water heater box is gonna clear the speaker, which is perfect. We gotta put one more bracket from the side of the speaker here back to the back corner of our firewall. That's how it's gonna be. So when you look at the truck, imagining that it's done and the glove box doors on and all that cool shit, you're never gonna see the speaker. And that's what's cool. You'd have to actually look up underneath the truck to see it. So that's one down. Now we gotta get to the driver's side one, which that one's gonna be a lot easier, because I'm actually gonna do a bolt-on application there where my bracket bolts onto the bracing right there. See the holes that are pre-punched, and you can see the bracket that I got made up. So we're gonna drill it there. We're gonna just bolt it on there at the top there, but then we are gonna have to weld it over there to make it secure. But man, that's one other thing down. And when we put our heater box in, it sticks out past this, so it protrudes. So that was the biggest thing, to make sure that this speaker with the cage on it, with this grill on it, did not come past this point here. Actually, it could have came out to about there, but I'll just use this as a reference. I want to stay behind that. Plus, I wanted it in this corner and back up in there. So it's gonna sound pretty good. So we got the 6.5 there. And then back here, we're gonna have 6x9 once we get our LS Fabrication speaker panel there. Turned out pretty good. Now I go to the other side, do that. Then we'll clean up all the brackets, get all the yellow off, and then paint them. And that's one more thing done. So here's my heater core, how it will be installed. And there's the speaker installed. So you can see we have plenty of room, plenty of clearance. And everything's gonna work out just right. So like I said, we gotta get over there and do the one underneath the driver's side. So for our speaker bracket on the driver's side, it's a little different than the ones that we have over there on the passenger side. And the reason for that is because, well, this is a piece of metal that I had and this is what we're gonna use. But actually, there's rhyme to the reason. You see that spot there and that spot there. I'll get into where that's gonna go. But what we're gonna be using to hold the speaker in place is these metal tapping screws or tech screws. So right now we have the holes marked. So I'm just gonna go ahead and drill my holes. So the bracket will be hanging over here in this corner like this. And why we have this hole here is because it's going to attach up there on the top of the steering column mount bracing coming off of the firewall, bringing its way to the dash. And then this side, why it's all shaved off like this, ground the bearers, because we're gonna weld this on top of where the cowl, there's a little spot up there, a ledge that we can weld this to secure it. Our bolt securing the bracket to our dash support. And then on the other end, over here by the cowl, we'll weld that on just right on top of there. So here we are, the day before Thanksgiving, 2020. And we're gonna figure out what we need to do. It's getting a little nippy out here. We're gonna have a spot of tea.
A spot of tea, old chum.
Just to keep a little toasty. It's not that cold out here. It's like 46 degrees, but we need to figure out what to do with this nonsense up here. So we got just a pair of pliers and we're gonna just pry this back. I'm hoping to pry it back, get it even, and then I can mend it with some weld, but then it's rippled here. So we'll try to do some straightening as well. As I said earlier, I'm not familiar with working with curved surfaces. It's going to be hard to get a dolly back here. I'll figure out something. But the cool thing about it is we get it straight enough and smooth and flat enough. We are using a matte colored paint to paint the interior of this truck. So any little imperfections or blemishes will be masked by way of the matte paint. So let's get to pulling this out. I got right where I can get to it. And I don't know what the hell happened. Like, how did it get ripped? I guess they started beating on it or whatever. So I'm just gonna try to pry it back evenly the best I can. And with this pair of pliers, maybe I ought to get a longer pair. What I'm trying not to do is damage this area here. Even though it won't have any effect on the window seal and all that, you still want this looking nice. It's a 5-window, man. You know? Jeez, that's the whole reason why I got the cab in the first place. So you know what? I'm gonna get a longer pair of pliers. I need my channel locks, but we're gonna use a set of needle nose. There we go. Get in there and try to pry that down and draw it even with its natural half. So now we got a little dent right here and we're gonna have to figure it out. So it's just gonna be a little bit of manipulating. I'm happy that I got this out. We need to get the other half out without creating any more damage. These little holes here from where they had metal tapping screws, putting the speakers in. We can just hit them with the welder, fill them. That's nothing. The other side is going to be a lot simpler. So we need to work on getting this straightened out. And I don't know, it might take a minute. So I'm going to get after that. All right, so we're going to try something. This is the piece I cut out. I've got the dent out of it, the crease that was in it. It's still thick enough to weld. And I'm going to use this, hopefully, use this as the reference to complete the rest up there. And what I mean by that is this has got such a contour. It goes out, then back in, then it's going to curve up like that. We can use this as the jump off if we can get this welded back in. I do believe it's thick enough. It's not thinned out that bad. It's not rusted out, rusted through. So it was just a little damaged. I'm gonna place it here, get it tacked on, and then just, you know, build the weld. Just keep building it. And then there's gonna be a gap. I'm using 35,000 wire. I'll be able to leave a sizable gap, 35,000 gap. So I'll be able to bridge the two pieces here. And then once I fill the gap, then I can join the two pieces of metal. And then I'll be able to use the heat from the weld and kind of get this to curve back like it's supposed to be. That's my plan anyway. We're gonna see what happens, how it works out. As I said, we're not out of anything. We're not gonna lose anything if we don't get this to work out the way that I planned. And if I have to cut it out a little bit more because I messed up, so what? We're gonna get this part fixed up one way or another. So that's what we're getting ready to do. Since we have bead roll firewall panels, bead roll toe boards, why not put a couple bead rolls? So I was saving this to use somewhere else and it didn't work out. So I kept it. And wouldn't it be kind of cool though? You know, it'd be like a custom touch. They wouldn't be, but asymmetrical. I like being asymmetrical. So this one would go over there. We could put this one here. Let's see. And it's curved like this because I was going to install it right there in front of the tunnel, but it's not going to work. And I don't want to do any extra cutting on the toe boards or anything. Everything on the floor is solid. So we don't want to disturb that just to make this work. So we got it curved. So obviously I've had to whack it, but that'd be kind of, man, that'd be kind of trick. I'd have to cut a little further up here so that this could fall into the pocket, but then still,
let me try that.
So I'm gonna whack this right now. I'm gonna whack this. So, let's see. Get that to go there. Gonna have to whack that there. But then will it fit? Let's see. Yeah, we'd have to jump some welds, it looks like. That ain't no hill for a stepper. Man, I think, let's see. We want the bead roll right there. Curve that down. Hell, I could weld some extra metal onto that. Man, that would be trick. Man, that would be cool. Man, but if I mess up, I'm going to be pissed. I'm going to do it. Fuck it, man. I'm going to do it. Just on the strength, just because. Shit. shit, it's within reason. I'm not gonna come all the way down. We're gonna just cut a little bit there. The main thing is to get the backside to go down in there. That way these would be flush. And as always, we cut inside of our square, you know, cut inside of our lines. Shit, yeah, man. I think I'm gonna do it. Let me do a little bit more planning right now. I'm in the moment. So just let me do a little bit more thinking here and we'll see what happens. I think it'd be cool. I just need to go to the other side and see if, because this one is larger. I wish I had another smaller piece like that. That hole is small, but I think that would look pretty cool. Wouldn't be another one like it. So that's what makes me think I'm gonna go with it. We'll see. All right, so we have it mocked up. We got our piece installed and it's looking pretty good. So now after it's been a couple hours of me trimming, like gradually trim. And right when I got pretty close to the end, I got a little wild and cut a little too much off of one side. Well, actually sanded too much off of one side, but that's okay. We have a gap here that's pretty big. So what I'm gonna do, I got some 18 gauge sheet metal. I also have some 16 gauge sheet metal. What I'm gonna do is where the gap is, I'm gonna have this piece of metal and stick this in the gap, just like this. And then tack it on to this panel and this panel. Then after it cools, I'll come back and cut it flush and then weld on this, the patch panel and the original panel. And then when it's time to grind everything down, we'll grind it down. It'll be a flush looking piece. It's either that or put this on the inside and make like a tab so that you can bridge that gap, jump the weld. I'm gonna do it this way. I'm gonna get a thicker piece. I think I'm gonna drop to a, or go up to a 18 gauge piece. This is, or I'm sorry. I think I'm gonna go up to a 16 gauge, which will be a little thicker than this 18. And it'll give me a lot more that I can pour the heat into. So we're just gonna try a couple things here and see if what we can come out with. But first thing we're gonna do is tack it where it's definitely able to be welded and get it held up in place before we begin putting the shims or wedges or whatever you want to call them in. I'm get to doing that. So after a little welding, that's what we got. So next we see we have this big gap here. What I have is another little piece that we're going to use to fill that gap. We're going to install that in there, flush, and then weld it in place. And then that will complete the whole run on this piece. So let me get to doing that and I'll show you the end result. So here's where the nonsense is going to start. We have to grind back some of our welds. As you've seen from the close-up shots, we do have a few welds that are piled on, kind of boogerish. Yeah, but we need to grind these back. We need to get our little fill piece in here, ground it flush with this part of the cab and our little patch panel. So we're gonna break out the grinder and be ever so careful just knocking down all this and try our best not to thin out any of the two pieces of metal that we're trying to join. So it's a good thing it's a 5-window. We can get our arm through the hole here. And just like with anything else, working with metal, you want to keep the heat range down. So we're gonna let this cool for a little bit because a lot of heat goes into the metal when you're grinding it as well. That'll thin things out. So we're just gonna let that cool, but then we're gonna continue knocking down the heavy welds, try to get it as smooth as possible. And then to do the finish work on smoothing everything out, we're gonna break out the die grinder because it's a little more precise with the little wheel. I can get in there and do the contours. So that's what we got so far. I need to weld these two pieces together once that cools down and then get this ground off and finish joining these two pieces here. So it's looking pretty good. And I'm pretty happy with the choice that I made. I gotta say, it looks pretty good to me. We just finished up the roughing in with the electric die grinder. I love this electric Milwaukee die grinder. It makes for a lot of ease, especially now in the wintertime. It's getting close to being wintertime, and with the air compressor and the air die grinder, you have to pay attention to what the temperature is outside. It's not heated in this building, so drawing in the cold air ends up creating ice in the lines and all that, yada, yada, yada. So we got it roughed in. I'm gonna give you guys a look at it. This is as far as I'm gonna grind it down, as far as I feel comfortable with grinding it down. I don't wanna thin everything out. And we got a couple spots I think I could probably hit, and I might do some touch up in a spot like right there, maybe right there. But for the most part, it looks good to me. I'm gonna smear coat it and then smooth everything out, and you'll never know, you know, that it was welded in. Obviously, you'll know that it was welded in because it doesn't come like this, but just to for appearance sake and everything, we'll smear coat it and sand everything down and get it nice and flush looking and uniform. So I'm gonna give you guys a close look at how it came out. So there's a closer look at what it is that we've done. As I said, there's a couple spots that need to be maybe touched up and filled in just a little more. I got a spot right there. I'd like to maybe smooth that out a little bit, but I think it's pretty cool. This part, that's just some old primer left over. It looks like a hole, but it's not. And I think that I'm satisfied with that. We can rough this in. We can smear coat this, get it all nice and even. And then I'm gonna clean out this and leave this portion of it bare metal while everything else around it is painted. So I think it's gonna be pretty dope. We gotta get over there to that side. So after we continue getting the other part over the five window fixed up, we're gonna move on to doing the dash. They hacked this up so bad. You can see the remnants of their Bondo and everything. So we just put a fill piece in, but we do have to continue stitching it around and then do the same thing like we just did back there. Grind everything flush. So I think we did pretty good for today. I'm excited about it. It's going to be pretty cool. A nice little addition to the truck. I'm going to clean that up, get it down to bare metal. Just need to get the sanding disc and get that all smooth and flushed out with the rest of the truck. But I want to take a break from doing the body work right now and attach my wire wheel brush and then start getting all of the inside of the cab down to bare metal. We want it to look like the dash here. I want to get this surface rust knocked off of here, off of the roof, and then also get it knocked off of the ceiling edges where we'd put the seals, and then come down the pillars and get everything cleaned up and get it prepared. It's getting close time for us to start putting in the sound deadener, but we gotta have everything cleaned up, everything sanded down, because we can't have sparks and all that stuff going on once we put that stuff down. So get up there, get this all knocked off. That's one of my plans for today, get everything down to bare metal and get it ready for the primer. Yeah.
step aside and put right behind.